Good morning. It's coming up to 7:15, and I'm starting early because the forecast is for it to be 25, 26 degrees today. So it's going to get pretty warm. I'm heading off nice and early. These are apparently fish restaurants. I've been cycling for about 9 kilometers, and there's probably been about 5 or 6 of these restaurants. I haven't told you where I am. I'm 8 kilometers north of Fossacesia Marina. And they obviously drop the net into the water and let the fish swim into the net. Clever idea. So obviously this cycle track is very popular because you can hire bikes quite easily all the way along this track. This is the railway station at San Vito. So this railway line hasn't been closed for that long. So on the one hand, the locals must regret the passing of the railway, but the cyclists must love the building of this track. This is a big old tunnel. And a long one as well. Why don't the bloody Italians tell you that road comes to an end? Oh, flaming nuisance. I've now got to cycle all the way back. Only about 3 kilometres, but annoying. I'm sitting in Ortano, about 20 kilometres, and I worked out last night that I've got about just under 1,000 kilometres to get back to Nice. So I reckon that's about 9-10 days riding. This is just south of Pescara. Like a little mini forest. This is Pescara. Taken from the top of an impressive cycle bridge. This is Padel, which is proving very popular in Italy. It's obviously on a much smaller court than tennis. It's not all beachfront cycle paths, unfortunately. This is a few kilometres north of Pescara, but there are beach bars, but far less crowded. I've now done 75 kilometres, and the vast majority of those kilometres have been done on this Adriatic cycle path. And apart from a few places where it stops and you have to go and join the main road, it has been a pleasure. After 110 kilometres, I've made it to Villa Rosa, and it's time for a swim. Okay, so that was a lovely cool swim, and the water is getting a little bit warmer. So the next priority is... Cheers!